The library? Come on, let's go in. What is he gonna tell us? Byakuya? You're making me nervous here, buddy. I hope you're not gonna screw us over here. Please don't. Ooh. Is the evidence that proves it was Genocide Jack really in the library?
Don't make me repeat myself.
So you want us to look out here for something, huh? Alright. Well, the first thing I want to do actually is check the room in the back and see what's in there, but I probably should investigate everything here first. Letter? There's no point in checking there. We need to find real clues. The lamp? Knock it off. What does the desk lamp matter right now? He's getting really pissed, isn't he? There's no point in checking there. We need to find real clues. Okay. Desk? There's no clues there. We need to check elsewhere. I think he means this room here. If I remember, on the other side of this door is the archive, right? Hurry up and go inside. Oh, here?
Let's go.
It'll all make sense once you're inside. What's in the archive? Lots of junk. Whoa, there's so many books and files. And so much dust too.
So in other words...
I wouldn't say there's enough value in this place to endure the dust. Oh, I would say. A couple of things to check out here. There's so many files stuffed under the shelf. What's in all these things?
That's enough.
These documents are dangerous. Dangerous. They detail all the people who control the world from behind the scenes. Dangerous truth from a commoner. Or for a commoner. You mean like members of the diet or something? No, I mean the ones with the real power. The secret council controlling everything from the shadows. If you're ready to be disappeared for it, take a look. There's some very interesting people in here. You're just kidding, right? Am I? I'll just let it go for now. Yeah, let's not have ourselves disappear. Okay. Lamp? Huh? It's a desk lamp. Oh yeah, it's the same one I saw Byakuya use in the library before.
What?
Do you have a problem with the lamp? It was here before, then I moved it over here. It's too dark over there. So I thought I'd put it to good use. Okay. What else we got here? The box. Check what's in here. There's a wooden box. It's empty. Although judging by the smudges and the dust, looks like there was something inside. I wonder what it was. There was an extension cord plugged in there. It proved very useful while I was in the library. An extension cord, huh? What is it trying to tell us here? The shelf is stuffed tight with files. Without really thinking about it, I picked one at random. Ah, you have a sharp eye indeed to select that file. Huh?
That's right.
That's the report on a presidential assassination. The original is kept at the National Library. It won't be declassified for another 30 years. Are you sure you want to look at it now? There's no telling whose crosshairs you might wind up in peeking at it. Without making a sound, I returned the file to the shelf. So what am I missing here? I'm clearly missing something. Reveal the ones with your power. Nope, I already saw that one. I don't need to look at that one. Okay, so this shelf is checked out. These shelves... There was a shelf behind him. Or maybe him. There's a ton of thick files stuffed on the bookshelf. If you're thinking of looking through any of them, let me give you a little warning. Those things are filled with graphic, disturbing photos from all kinds of crime scenes. It's the kind of thing any normal person wouldn't ever want to look at. Be careful. Huh? What do you mean? All those files there are investigation reports related to different cold cases. Those are internal documents for police eyes only. They're not the kind of thing you'd expect to leak. Oh! So, are you finally beginning to understand the true splendor of this library? The entire reason I was interested in a library is because of this room right here.
Interesting.
It's the home to classified government documents, police records, things no ordinary person would ever see. Isn't it magnificent? This can be for real, right?
Such ignorance.
That's your guys' problem. Anything that doesn't fit into your preconceived reality, you label it a lie. Well, it's not that. It's not like I totally refuse to believe it, but... I mean, there's just so much. How could anyone have put all this together? I suppose it goes to show just how much power Hopespeak truly wields. Or perhaps... the mastermind may have wanted to provide us with enough entertainment to keep us from getting bored. It's no use. I can't keep up with all this. It's just too unreal. I feel like Hopespeak used to be the academy for the ultimates and they probably, you know, house a lot of, I guess, people that would work eventually in the government jobs and everything and would, you know, become specialists in government affairs and murder cases and stuff like that. But then somebody took it over. I'm guessing that's what happened. And this is, which is why all these files are here. What's wrong? You still can't believe it? What about you? How can you believe it so easily? Things like that are usually impossible.
What?
What do you mean usually? Usual? Normal, ordinary, simple? Those things don't exist anywhere in the real world. If you don't understand what they actually represent, you don't understand the nature of anything. You don't pull your punches, do you? Besides, what you consider usual is based on your common sense, right? What makes you think of your own common sense applies to me at all? But what makes you think... Oh wait, hold on, let me try that again. But what makes you think your own common sense applies to me at all? The documents gathered here are genuine. I've reviewed them multiple times, so there's no doubt. Hold on a second. You're saying you've read all these documents? And more than once? But all this has to be like top secret, confidential stuff, right? So why? Why not? My family has a reading room just like this at our home. Ours is bigger, of course, and not as dusty. Huh? Members of the Tagami family have access to any variety of government-related documents. That includes foreign power as well as domestic. How's that even possible?
So in other words...
I already told you. There's a secret council that controls the world from the shadows. Oh god. The Illuminati! The Illuminati! The Illuminati has invaded DanganRonpa even! My family is a member of that council. And how within me the bloodline that will allow me to one day become the world, to bend the world to my will. But to become such a ruler, I must know all levels of the world backwards and forwards. So whenever I have time, I like to review whatever documents and materials that interest me. Which is why I can proclaim without a doubt that the materials gathered here are the real thing. This is beyond believing or not believing. BYAKUYA is actually starting to scare me more than the actual mastermind. And what always interests me the most were the cold case police investigation reports. Reading through those reports has always been a hobby of mine, ever since I was little. He didn't probably have a good childhood, did he? Reading cold case reports, I don't know, maybe he had a messed up childhood. It's excellent mental exercise. I've solved more than a few of those cases just by reviewing the reports. And among all those reports, one of my recent favorites is the Genocide Jack case. As he talked, BYAKUYA grabbed a specific file from the shelf.
That's right.
This is the complete case file. Every single report surrounding the Genocide Jack case has been compiled in here. Because there are so many, allow me to quickly summarize the main points. To begin, there are two notable characteristics in every Genocide Jack murder. The first characteristic is that at every crime scene, the word bloodlust is written in the victim's own blood. And the second is that when victims are murdered, the bodies are suspended in a certain way. Really now? Bloodlust is written in blood, and the victim's body suspended, so it must not be a copycat case, is it? So Genocide Jack is actually among us. It's exactly the same as what happened to Chihiro. Save your surprise, the best part is yet to come. For the second characteristic, where the victims are suspended. The only ones who knew about the particular fact were members of the police and other higher-ups. By all accounts, nobody in the media ever found out. Huh? In other words, no one on the news, no one online, nobody knew about the aspect of each crime. Only key officials and the killer himself knew about this act of mounting the victim. Now, if you recall Chihiro's corpse, her body was most certainly mounted in this fashion. So, how could the killer have known about suspending the victim?
That's right.
That's the key question. But in fact, the answer is quite simple.
So in other words...
the culprit isn't a copycat killer. It's the real Genocide Jack. Okay, so that kind of proves it, because from what he said, nobody in the news or media or internet knew that victims were suspended. They knew that Bloodlust was written, but nobody knew that was suspended. So the fact that somebody's actually suspended Chihiro after writing Bloodlust, meaning they are either a cop that knew about this, or they are themselves Genocide Jack, which nobody here is a cop, I don't think. So probably Genocide Jack is in the school. Well, shit. Alright.
In other words...
That right there is the evidence that Genocide Jack has hidden himself among the rest of us. Then, Genocide Jack really is such a brutal, fiendish killer, is walking among us?
Interesting.
Things are really starting to get interesting, aren't they? I never imagined a killer with such a reputation would ever become part of our little game. Now, don't you think it would be good for you to take a look at what I've already seen? Wait, hold on. Now, don't you think it would be good for you to take a look at what I've already seen? Oh, him? You might just manage to ferret out a clue or two.
Such ignorance.
If you get down on your knees and beg, I might even show you myself. So he wants us to actually investigate this. It's gotta be the documents behind him. A ton of thick files stuffed on the bookshelf. All those files are investigation reports related to different cold cases. Those are internal documents of police eyes only. They're not the kind of thing you'd expect to leak. Wait, I already seen all this. Nope, that's not it either. Okay. That's what the power cord was in. That's for presidential stuff. Also, there's a camera up here. Oh, something here. Oh, the camera. There we go. Am I missing anything here? I'm trying to be very thorough. I should probably investigate everything, shouldn't I? Just in case.
That's right.
Nope. That's presidential case. No, that's the one about the people with power. That's the lamp. This is the extension cord. So what am I missing now? Hold on one sec, let me look through this. Truth bullets map. Is it truth bullets that we need? Monokumo file, okay. Nope. Something that he said. Maybe I just gotta ask him. Let's just ask him. Byakuya, about the Genocide Jack case file, could you let me see it?
That's fine.
Well, you didn't beg, but I guess it's okay this time. Feel free to look at it in here, but you can't take it with you. No problem. So what are we gonna see there? Byakuya handed me the file, and I flipped through it with tense, nervous fingers. That'd be good, in case I wanted to use this as a thumbnail. My bad. I don't know what I did there, but I'm gonna go ahead and keep on going. I don't remember which is the key to bring up the transcript, but whatever. I had reached the page where photos from the scene of each crime had all been collected. The names of Genocide Jack's victims ran on for several pages. Jesus, they've all been impaled the same way, except these use scissors. Kent Harada, 32. Tetsuhiro Honda, 17. Shoji Gaku, 23. Kano Issei, 14. Takeshi Yoshida, 30. Komatsuna Taro, Takifumi Gono, Uchida Naohisa, Takashi Masamune, Yuto Yujimina, there was no end to it. But one thing became perfectly clear as I read. All of the killers count victims were killed and suspended in exactly the same way. And all the at the scene of every murder, the word bloodlust was left in the victim's own blood. Now take a look at the next page and you'll find another interesting tidbit. The next page. What are we gonna see? Profiling results. All of the crimes took place either on weekdays at night or during holidays, either day or night. The most common time for the killing to take place was on holiday in the afternoon. Based on these facts, it was suggested that the suspect may be a student. Evidence suggests that a suspect lingered at the scene, but when they did leave, they were in a panic. Because an eyewitness had never come forward, it's unlikely there was any external reason for this. This confused behavior suggests that the suspect may potentially suffer from dissociative identity disorder. Oh god, this totally confirms Toko might be the murderer. Dissociative identity disorder. Meaning the murderer snaps into Genocide Jack and then snaps out of it and then leaves all confused. Oh shit. Okay, Toko is clearly the killer here. Clearly.
So in other figured words, out.
The key point here is that the culprit may well have a split personality. A split personality? Just like the kind of thing you see on TV? So I'm part of another totally unbelievable story. But this one is way more unbelievable than anything else up until now. Or maybe it really isn't. I don't know. I feel like my mind has gone numb. Genocide Jack case file has been added to the Truth Bullets section of your handbook.
Let's go.
Alright, we should get going soon. Huh? Where are we going?
Hmm.
Anyway, but here. We've finished our business here, haven't we? Wait, Byakuya? He's clearly onto something, which is good. As usual, Byakuya turned and left without another word. I hurried out of the library to catch up. Well, this is where we part ways. I have some things I need to take care of before the class trial. Huh? Just all of a sudden like that?
I don't have time to play with
Come on.
You.
Come on. Enough of your annoying misapprehensions. Did you really think we'd be together the whole time? Take responsibility for yourself and do something useful. Move the investigation forward on your own.
Goodbye.
Well, goodbye. And just like that, he was gone. Just as quickly as they'd asked me to join him, he cut me off. In the end, I feel like I was just some plaything getting tossed around. At the same time, I'd uncovered some really important clues thanks to him. Genocide Jack, he's the one that killed Chihiro. That murderous fiend is one of us. But who is it? I have to find that out, no matter what it takes. And to do that, there's somewhere I have to go to investigate one more time. I have to go back to the crime scene, the girls' locker room. I shake the boys' locker room too. And the others might have come up with some info I might find useful while I'm at it. I need to find out everything I can. Clearly, Byakuya is probably gonna go back to Toko because she did mention a promise. So clearly they interacted before. Clearly. I wanna check this room here just in case. I don't know what's in there. But I'm very suspicious of their interaction. Very, very, very suspicious. Realities and everything. Okay. See the area? Yep, I'm gonna go ahead and do it. Clearly there's a reason behind all this. Clearly, and I kinda wanna figure out what it is. You know, like, what is he hiding? Kinda wanna check it out just in case, see if maybe he is in a room or something. Or next to her room. See if you can go investigate that. Good thing I learned about the sprint. Oh god, he scared me. Good thing I learned about the sprint button. Let's see if you can go through here. Go along this. There we go. Alright. I want to see if he's near her room or not. Maybe we can investigate her room again. Check the room here. Well, actually, let me do this. Oh, wrong thing. Map. Somebody's in a warehouse. She's in the dining hall. Maybe we can knock on Toko's room one more time. Let me just save here, just in case. Never know what's gonna happen. Maybe she'll jump out as Genocide Jack and kill us. Cause another genocide. This is Toko's room. I should probably just leave her alone for now. What about Byakuya's room? Where's he at? Let's check here. Actually, I could just use a minimap. Byakuya is here, actually. This is Byakuya's room. I doubt there's any clues here. I mean, no. It could be, possibly. Maybe. Can't rule anything out, really. I should probably return back to the second floor, shouldn't I? That might be the best thing to do right now. Just go ahead and piece this investigation little by little, like we did originally before with Psych as murderer. You know, just kind of figure everything out. Take notes of everything that is going on, everything that's happened. So we know the Genocide Jack has a split personality. We already know somebody here has a split personality already, which makes it our investigation a little bit easier to control. I guess not really control, but I guess rotate in. Toku has a split personality, I'm pretty sure, because when she did hit her head, her personality changed. Huh. I don't know. I think what I'm gonna do actually is just save right here, and we'll probably come back onto this. It's so good! I know I wanna, I know you're probably saying like, no, continue, keep playing. But I wanna take a break here, so we can come back later and continue this investigation further with a clear mind after I compiled all the necessary notes, and also look up the guides, or maybe play a little bit of Monocoins roulette, just to see what we can get from it. You know, some gifts and items for social interactions and all that stuff. Maybe. I might do it later though. Nevertheless though, I hope you enjoyed the episode. I'm gonna go ahead and go right now and see if maybe I can record something else. I'm out for the summer break, although we'll have summer classes and everything, so technically not on break really, but still, no more finals, so that's nice. I think I might just stay up a little bit more and record, since it's like, what, 2 in the morning? Yeah, like 3 in the morning, wow, shit. Anyway, hope you enjoyed. My name is Tamriel. Like, subscribe, and as always, have a great day. See ya. Hey guys, how's it going? My name is Samriel. Welcome to Hello, what have we got here? Hello ladies, how's it going? Breasts are the treasure of the net. I kinda wanna say you could dress better.